Welcome. We are so glad that you have chosen to join us today. We pray that you are blessed by the music and the ministry of the service you are about to participate in. We are so glad that you have chosen to be here, and we pray that you are blessed. Now, if this is your first time, we ask that you let us know where you're watching from, because we have people in so many different countries. And if this message touches you, if there's something that blesses you, please leave a comment, give us a thumbs up, a heart. We just love it when you show your praise for what God is ministering to you. It's not for us. This is all about Him. So we want you to be a participant, not just an observer in this service with us today. And if there's some way that you need to contact us, if you have a question, if you need prayer, if you need a Bible, our information will be at the end of the video where you can reach out to us, you can call us, you can message us through Facebook. There's so many different ways, but mainly you can visit our central hub at godspeedministry.com, and all of the information is there. And if you want to continue your worship through giving, which is always goes to God, then we invite you to do that also through our central hub, godspeedministry.com. Now, let's get into why you came, into the message.
Yes, I've had dreams. I've even held them in my hand. I never knew those dreams could slip right through. Like they were only grains of sand. The anchor holds, though the ship is battered. The anchor holds, though the sails are torn. I have fallen on my knees as I face the raging sea. The anchor holds, in spite of the storm. Well, I have been young, now I'm older, and there has been beauty these eyes have seen. It was there in the night, through the storms of my life, that's where God proved His love for me. Anchor holds. Though the ship is battered, the anchor holds. Though the sails are torn, I have fallen on my knees as I face the rain. The anchor holds in spite of the storm. I have fallen on my knees as I face the raging seas. The anchor holds in spite of the storm.
The reason that I'm a Godspeed chaplain is, the first reason is I love cars. Not more than I love God, but I love cars a lot. It's a close second. And at the 2003 IHRA Division 14 Finals in Shreveport, we went to a Godspeed ministry service, and that was our first year to compete in IHRA. And on the way back to the pits on the golf cart, my youngest son sitting behind me said, "Dad, why don't we have church at our racetrack?" And that little golf cart turned around and went right back up there, and I talked to the Godspeed chaplain, got me connected with Renee, and here you go. And I've been doing it ever since and love serving. But on the right-hand sleeve of the shirts that we're all wearing is the scripture, Isaiah 61:1. "The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to those who are bound." Now, I'm going to preach today on the anointing in the second part of that. But what I want you guys to think about is, so who is this gospel for that we've been anointed to go and preach and share with? Is it just for the chaplains? Is it for the racers? Is it for the sinners? Is it for the saints? Is it for the believers and non-believers? The gospel is for everybody. And I want to break down this scripture just a little bit. When Jesus says the poor, good tidings to the poor, he's not talking about those who lack financial resources. He means the meek, the humble, the lowly, and most certainly those who are poor in spirit. And when he talks about the brokenhearted, he's not talking about those of us who had our heart jilted by our fourth grade sweetheart. He's talking about those who are weary and are suffering sorrow and guilt for their sins, and they seek peace. And for the captives, he's talking about those who have been captured by the devil and they live a life of just continuing to do his will. And the oppressed, those are those who are being held captive by their sin and live under the guilt and the shame that the sinful life brings to each and every single one of us. Charles Spurgeon puts it like this: "You do not really preach the gospel if you leave Christ out. If he is omitted, it's not the gospel. You may invite men to listen to your message, but you are only inviting them to gaze upon an empty table unless Christ is the very center and substance of all that you set before them." Usually when I preach, I always try to preach something that has to do a little bit with racing. I try not to preach the gospel of Steve or the gospel of Chevrolet, but the gospel of Jesus Christ. And so when I look at this scripture and I see the word anointed, the first thing that comes to my mind is oil. And I think about oil, and I've talked about this several times before, and I think about the oil that we all put in our race car engines, and I think about the importance of what oil does and how oil serves as a barrier between us and friction and heat and stress, and it makes the engine run so much more smoothly. And one thing I've noticed a lot about racing engine, and you top sportsman guys know, the bigger the engine, the more the oil. And you don't run a dipstick on a race car engine. There's no way to check the oil. You automatically know a predetermined amount of oil that's going to go in that engine every time it's rebuilt, changed, or changed out. I've got a regular bottle of Napa motor oil right here. And right on the back of the motor oil, it says it's guaranteed to fight rust and corrosion, sludge and deposits. It aids in cold weather starts, protects in high temperatures, and it's approved for use in almost every vehicle. So my question is, if you only had to change your oil in your race car one time, and you could put this one particular oil in your race car, and it would stay there forever, you never had to change it again, it was going to stay the same the whole time, you don't even have to change the filter, wouldn't that be the motor oil that you would run? See, the motor oil that I'm talking about today is the blood of Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus Christ, if we accept it one time, it's a predetermined amount that will celebrate it on the cross on Friday. An amount that covers all of our sins, that covers everything that we've ever done, everything that we're ever going to do. And all we got to do is just check it every once in a while. The good news is here's the filter right here. You do got to filter it. You got to use the word of God. You see, when Jesus was talking about the poor and the brokenhearted and the captives and the oppressed, he was talking about the people we walk among every day. And I don't know about your track, but at our track, drag racing sure seems to mask a lot of the messed up things that are going on in people's lives. I have a phenomenal, phenomenal congregation at the Abilene Racetrack. It's not uncommon for us to have 45 or 50 people on a Sunday morning when we race. We had 200 people in the grandstands at Walter Morrill's funeral. I had the absolute joy of baptizing a funny car racer at San Antonio Pro-Am several years ago. And it wasn't because of anything I did. It was because I was willing to accept the anointing or the rubbing on or the application of oil, which sets us aside to serve those that we're called to serve. And kind of like you, Tommy, some of us that are serving, we need to have our oil changed and checked pretty frequently, because we've been down some pretty rough roads as well. But because of the loving, giving mercy and grace of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, that's all behind us now. That's all in the last round, not the next round. That's all behind us. So what does it mean to be anointed, to smear or rub oil on? I think a lot of times people are put off, or they're nervous, or they think that maybe we're special, or that we're special. We're not. We're just like them. We've only accepted the application of the oil. We've only accepted the anointing to go and preach this gospel, this good news that we've been called to preach. So I go back to my question, and it's something you can talk to these guys about. It's a subject you can bring up, because all these guys want to talk about your cars. I've never met a race car driver, a racer, car owner didn't want to talk about his car. My wife says, if you want to get me talking for 10 minutes, ask me about my grandkids. You want to get me talking for 10 hours, get me talking about my race car. But I'm working on that, I promise you. So what we need to do is we need to spread this gospel, and we need to encourage people, no matter where they are, no matter what they've done, what happened on the cross that we celebrated on Friday was so that a predetermined amount of God's grace and mercy and love for us in the form of his blood will spill out on us to fill us up and to cover everything we've ever done. I always tell everybody my favorite motor oil is this right here. It's JC SAE 316. That's my favorite motor oil right there. I keep that with me all the time. But we struggle, and we struggle all the time. My mom used to always say, Stephen, she said, some people are just geared to go uphill. And we know a lot of people who like to carry a heavy load, and they like to carry everybody else's load. And they need to be especially anointed and filled with the power of the blood of Jesus Christ, so they can continue to carry that heavy load and they can continue to move forward going uphill the whole time. Because that's where the viscosity and the oil breaks down, is when we're under a heavy load. All we got to do is reach into the filter and go to the Word. Find the Word of Jesus Christ. Find how it applies to every situation that we're in. And when we find that situation and apply it, we notice that our level seems to be topped off just a little bit. We do it when we go to communion. I can only imagine being in the room when he took the cup and he poured the wine and he said, "This is the blood of the new covenant. Take and drink this as often as you do." So one thing I want to share with you guys is Jeremiah 29:11. I know everybody knows it. It says, "For I know the thoughts that I have for you and think for you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope." That scripture right there tells you that a predetermined amount of Christ's blood was shed for each and every one of us. It's just the right amount. It's just exactly what we need to get through this crazy old mixed up world that we're in. I miss my church family, my little church family at the track. I can't wait to see them again. And, you know, the national doctor is telling us we're not going to be shaking hands again. Well, he hadn't said anything about hugging yet, because there's going to be a lot of hugging going on. I got the absolute joy yesterday of leading the prayer before a practice tree race on Zoom, where 32 racers joined together and asked me to pray over their race before they started. And it was amazing. It was amazing to hear the voices of all the racers and the friends and know that they were covered in the blood. And so the last thing that I want to go over today is I want everyone to think about, I love racing. I'm not currently racing right now, but we're going to the races all the time and meeting the people out here in West Texas and taking care of them. But, you know, Friday was the day that we celebrated perfection on the tree. Every racer wants to be perfect on the tree, or as close to perfect as he can, to get that advantage, to get that jump. But Friday was the day that we celebrated what real perfection on the tree looked like. And it was in the form of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who shed that blood to fill us up and cover every single one of our sins. I'm so excited to be able to start doing this stuff on Zoom. I'm so excited to start putting my kind of twisted twist, is what my wife calls it, on the gospel and how I usually wrap it into racing or something practical. Sometimes I do it with plumbing. I'm a plumber by trade, but she discourages me from doing that when I can. So I want to close y'all with this short prayer and on my message today. Father God, we thank you, Lord. We thank you that you were perfect on the tree on Friday. And we're so thankful that the first light we saw was when you rose up on Sunday morning, and that all the blood you shed was to fill us up a predetermined amount to cover all of our sins and the predetermined plan that you have for our lives. Father God, as we as chaplains move forward and preach the gospel and the good news to the poor, the brokenhearted, the bound up, the blind, the oppressed, Father God, give us the strength. Keep us full. Most of all, Father God, keep us faithful and let us tell the truth. For you are the way, the truth, and the life. Amen. Thank you all so much for today.
We pray you were blessed by today's message. We have some amazing people who are willing to go to the four corners of this nation to tell you about the gospel of Jesus Christ. And if something in the message today, in the service, of the music, or whatever you saw or heard, touched you, and you want to reach out to us, please do so. Our information will be here. You can reach out to the ministry at 704-473-4212. Or you can get all of our information at GodspeedMinistry.com. We want you to know God personally, powerfully, and passionately. Because we are preparing to become His bride when He returns for us, or when we leave this earth. So we want to make sure that you have that relationship with Him. That's our main priority. is not just to give you a head knowledge, but a heart knowledge. To be adopted by the King of the universe and the Lord of lords, and to have all your sins washed away so that you walk in victory in this world. Godspeed Ministry exists to connect people to God and then to each other in service to bring other people who are hurting, lost, worried, confused, and afraid into the saving knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. And if that's you, make sure that you reach out to us. You can reach out to us in the comments and Messenger, and again at godspeedministry.com. We look forward to hearing from you. And if this message was a blessing to you and you are already walking with God and this just fired you up to walk even closer with Him, leave us a heart and let us know. We'll see you in heaven. Godspeed.